If you've seen my Remaking Super Mario World in Godot series, you've seen me use this font in my videos. It's a computer font that's made to look like the one from Super Mario World. And I actually made it myself, more or less. If you're wondering what part is more and what part is less, if you've ever wondered what an illusi yellow is, or if you just started wondering that now, or if you just want to know how you can use this font for yourself right now, then this seems like a pretty good video to watch. Hi there, I'm Y and I like fonts. But I'm not a font expert by any means, just a casual fan. Heck, my favorite font is Helvetica. You can also tell I'm not an expert because I keep calling it font. The professional typographers out there will probably be upset if I don't use the proper term typeface. But we all know what I mean, right? At least if you've ever typed anything on a computer, you probably know what a font is. But what is it technically? These days, a font file is basically a collection of vector graphics. Every character in the font is defined by some control points and smooth curves between those points. The font doesn't come with an image of the letter A, it just has the instructions for how to draw the lines to make the letter A. That way you can make the text as big as you want and it'll stay smooth. There are other formats such as bitmap fonts, where the characters actually are stored as images, but as far as I know they're pretty rare, and almost any font you come across today will be in a vector format. Fonts come in all sorts of styles, and you can spend as long as you like sorting them into categories. Serif, sans serif, geometric, humanist, black letter, handwritten, and so on if you want to. In this video, I'm focusing on the category of pixel fonts. They are fonts where the characters are made of clearly visible pixels in a grid, reminiscent of old computers or retro video games. I think pixel fonts are some of the few that would actually work fine in a bitmap format. The letters are made of only straight lines, so it shouldn't be as much of a problem to store them as images. But in practice, even pixel fonts are in a vector format these days. Same as pretty much every other font, except the curves just happen to all be straight lines. In the past, making fonts was something only typographers could do. But in the not past, there are tools that let you create and edit vector graphics, or maybe take pictures of your own handwriting and convert that into vectors. So now anyone can make a font, and many people do. There's no shortage of fonts made by amateurs. Often they're fan-made fonts that emulate the style of some other media. For example, this Star Wars font is not actually the font used in Star Wars. It's a font someone made after the fact that looks like Star Wars. For any movie or game you can think of, chances are someone's made a font for it. And of course, when you do that to old video games, you end up with fan-made pixel fonts. And that's what this video is about. But before we get to the font I made, we need to talk about the one that came before it. It shouldn't be a surprise that someone had already made a Super Mario World font before I did. The first one, as far as I can tell, was made by someone named Sam in 2010. And the font file is called Illusi Yellow. Illusi Yellow? Illusi Yellow. Now, what does that mean? To understand that, let's take a look at how Super Mario World handles text. Being an SNES game, Super Mario World doesn't use a font as we know it. Pretty much everything, except the moving parts, is displayed as tiles on a grid. Any text in the game is also just a grid of tiles. Just like the foreground, for example. Except the tiles are 8x8 pixels large instead of 16x16, and they just happen to look like letters. Here's the graphics file that contains these letters. They're used in message boxes and also to show level names on the overworld map. Because the tiles are in a grid, the number of letters is predefined. You can't squeeze in any more tiles. But some level names actually are too long to fit. In particular, the names Yellow Switch Palace and Forest of Illusion, plus the level number, are both just one letter too long. So, the game has to have entirely new, separate tiles where the letters are drawn closer together, so the text uses one fewer tile in total. And those tiles have to be stored somewhere in the graphics file. Hence, the iconic Illusi Yellow. So, when the old fan-made Super Mario World font was created, I assume it was named that as an homage to this quirk. And the old font has been serving people very well for years. But it's not without its shortcomings. The lowercase b is a pixel higher than the rest, there are two pixels missing in the number 5, and in general, although that's not really its fault, the letter heights and spacings are pretty wonky. I thought maybe it was time to update the font, So, a while ago, first out of boredom and then out of ambition, I set out to make my own Super Mario World font. At first, my plan was just to take the old Illusiello font and make some small adjustments to it, like fixing the number 5. I downloaded a font editing tool and opened the font file with it, and there were the vectors, or in this case, straight lines. But I found it pretty tedious to edit them, although that's probably on me, not the tool. Making all the changes I want by dragging points around and hoping they'll end up in a straight line didn't seem like the way to go. After all, this is a pixel font. I should be able to just draw shapes with pixels and then convert them into a font file, right? And then I found a tool that does exactly that. This is an online tool called Pixel Font Converter, and it's really straightforward. You give it an image with a grid of letters, then type out the letters in the same order so the tool knows what each letter is, and it spits out a font file. So I made an image with all of the Super Mario World characters arranged in a grid. In this format, it's really easy to make changes. I can adjust some characters and I can draw new characters that weren't there before. When I showed my progress to some friends on Discord, they asked me to add some letters from their own languages, so I did. I ended up making a lot more changes than I thought. For one thing, instead of every character having the same width, the tool can auto-detect how wide the letters are, so the spacing already looks a lot better. Then I added a little curve to the letters T and L, so they're easier to read. But most importantly, I changed the ascenders and descenders. But the typography experts will probably be upset if I don't use the proper term sticky outy bits. In most fonts, you have a consistent letter height with all the letters lining up in the middle, and the ascenders and descenders go above and below those lines, also in a consistent way. In Super Mario World, every character had to fit in an 8x8 square, so there really wasn't room for ascenders and descenders, and everything looked kinda cramped. But now I didn't have that limitation, so I gave the letters some much-needed breathing room and consistency. The final thing I did was kerning. That's where you adjust the spacing between two letters, so that specific pair looks nicer together. It's like fine-tuning the spacing. For example, if the uppercase T and the lowercase O have their default spacing, that's bad kerning. But if the O fits snugly underneath, that's probably still bad kerning because I'm just eyeballing it. But I did what I could, and the tool lets you do it really easily. And so, in a fit of extreme boredom, I went through every single letter pair to adjust the kerning by hand. Like I said, I was really just eyeballing it, and halfway through I started using half pixels as a unit instead of full pixels, so this is probably not up to any professional standard. But I iterated on it quite a bit, and now I'm really happy with how it looks. Everything I've written with this so far has looked perfectly fine. And when all that was done, all I had to do was export the font file. I don't really understand these settings here, and apparently I've used them wrong, but those were the only settings that worked, so oh well. I should mention that apparently the TTF files this tool generates don't support kerning for some reason, so I had to download the font in the OTF format and convert it to TTF with some online converter, and that seemed to do the trick. And there we have it, the new Super Mario World font. Overall, after all the changes and new characters and ascenders and descenders and kerning, my new font doesn't really have that much in common with Super Mario World anymore. But it definitely still feels like Super Mario World, and that's enough for me. Like I mentioned earlier, this font is available for anyone to use right now. I've uploaded it to my GitHub. You can see the source files there, and put them into the Pixel Font Converter tool to edit the font if you want. Or if you just want to use it, click on the release link and download the font file. Thank you so much for watching. And that wasn't Helvetica, by the way, but thanks for commenting.